Sukan, Namaskar, Vanakkam. My dear scientists who are all working in this prestigious institution, the children who got some awards today, their parents and brothers and sisters, I am really happy to be here today at this National Institute of Ocean Technology on the occasion of its Silver Jubilee celebrations. For information, it is on my request, I am visiting your institution. Not that I have not received, I have received an invitation. But after becoming Vice President, I made it a mission to go around the country, visit various education institutions, research institutions, technological institutions, cultural bodies, agriculture research institutes, and others, and interact with them, know what is happening, understand the opportunities that are being provided, and also the challenges they are facing in, and also appreciate the good work done by these institutions and the people working in that. That I have made as a mission of my institution as Vice President of India. And this occasion is a very important occasion because of Silver Jubilee. My heartiest congratulations to both NIOT and the Minister of Earth Sciences for their successful voyage and reaching this milestone. I am happy to note that NIOT is carrying out the state-of-art research in ocean-related field. Apart from having demonstrated technologies like desalination plants for the island communities, I've been explained that NIOT, among others, is engaged in data collection for tsunami warning and also beach restoration, which gives immense benefits to the society. As a Vice President, I visited the Indian Center for Ocean Information Service in COIS and the National Tsunami Warning Center located in Hyderabad last year, June in 2018. I am informed that NIOT is also working towards developing deep sea mining system with technologies for harnessing resources from ocean to meet country's growing mineral requirements and increase in the country's self-sufficiency in the near future. The development of technologies for the sustainable harvesting of living and non-living resources of the ocean is in line with the blue economic policy of the Government of India, and it will empower the nation to be a leader in oceans like space and in areas like space technology. It is a matter of pride that NIOT is carrying out state-of-art research on par with the international ocean research organizations. The importance of oceans is not new to us. And our epics spoke of Samudra Manthan thousands of years ago. India's connection to the ocean-related activities like naval warfare and trade dates back to ancient times. The oldest port of Lothal and the first century Chola port of Pumpuhar are examples of our connection with marine infrastructure development. A Roman report describes how the trade vessels were escorted by the king's fleet from the Pumpuhar port to the estuary, as it was a natural harbor in the mouth of River Kaveri. Mamallapuram, which has recently hosted the meeting between the Honorable Prime Minister Sri Narendra Bhai Modi and Honorable President of the People's Republic of China Sri Jinping, was a significant port city during the Pallava period in 7th century. It was also a thriving port until the end of 9th century, with the town being part of China's Silk Road and India's Spice Road. Kanchipuram silk industry owes its genesis to the import of raw silk from China through Mamallapuram, starting from Ashoka. All Indian rulers, especially Rajendra Chola, have shown their prowess over the seas, and therefore we have traditionally acquired the knowledge of creating marine infrastructure like landing jetties, mid-sea transfers of material from huge crafts to small boats, and transport of material through estuaries. I understand the that the mission of NIOT is to develop world-class technologies and their application for sustainable utilization of ocean resources. To provide competitive value-added technical services and solutions to organizations working on ocean-related activities and to develop a knowledge base and institutional capabilities in India for management of ocean resources and environment. I am happy to note that NIOT's research includes detailed engineering for creation of sustainable coastal and offshore infrastructure, ocean data collection capability, marine geochemistry, marine pollution, oceanography, marine ecology, marine drugs, and mariculture technologies. Technologies needed for protection of coastal areas from negative impact of climate change and for development of blue coastal infrastructure for the benefit of society. I am happy to note that NIOT is carrying out real-time ocean conservation network in polar region for long-term monitoring of Arctic region for climate change studies. India's coastline is over 7,500 kilometers long, and even this state, the beautiful and dutiful state of Tamil Nadu is also having a long coast. And it provides livelihood to sustainable population by enhancing global trade, especially those related to marine and coastal environments, which constitute a key resource for economic development. Jay Kumar was telling me that he was here in 1993 when this foundation was laid for this institution. Of course, he was a fisheries minister then, now also fisheries minister, constantly taking care of fisheries. I am also pleased to note that NIOT is working on almost all aspects of 6 priority pillars of blue economy: fisheries and aquaculture, renewable ocean energy, seaports and shipping, offshore hydrocarbons and seabed minerals, marine biotechnology, research and development of tourism. All 6 are very important in the progress of this nation. I'm very happy that you people are focusing your attention on these 6 pillars of blue economy. Your director has explained to me when coming in the progress that is being made. All these aspects are very important for the country's future, because food, environmental protection, energy, and also the water. I am sure in the coming days, this process of desalination will get further impetus, because I am worried that we may face water problem and water challenges. Some people are suggesting that there may be water wars across the globe. So that being the case, we must try to utilize the available seawater. And for that, you need to do more and more research. You have already found some solution, but it has to be cost-effective. Because converting saline water to potable water, sweet water, is a very good thing that will solve the problem to maximum possible extent. But the question is, at what cost? That is the issue. So like, scientific research is going around the globe. Many of the countries, some of the island countries have visited, they are all depending on only this desalination. We are a huge country, 130 crore population. And our requirement also is huge. So that we have to focus our attention on the future challenges along with the present challenges. We are also developing population. Unfortunately, country as a whole, and we are not focusing enough attention on population planning, family planning and population planning. Politicians are a little sensitive. The moment you touch family planning, and then your political family planning may be taken care by those people. I don't think so. If you are doing something good by educating the people for their own welfare, space is the same, land is the same, water, the other resources that are available are the same. And then population is growing. How do you manage it? And a country where you still have 20% below poverty line, poverty. You have 18-20% illiterates. And you have other challenges. And you have a huge challenge which is coming across the globe of climate change. With all this, you have to really plan family size also. And take care of the future. Okay, more and more people is fine. There has to be more and more enjoyment now. Mere prosperity alone will not suffice. You need to have happiness. And happiness is provided if you are able to take care of all their needs, their physical requirements, and also give them scope for better living conditions. We are all seeing now the air pollution, which is now really becoming very hazardous. And also climate change that is happening. You people in Chennai, you have seen the serious flood situation, these tsunamis, the cyclones frequently, and the floods and all. It's all natural calamities because we have started neglecting the nature. That's why wherever I am going, I am suggesting to the people of the country, love and live with the nature. Love and live with the nature. Nature, culture, together for better future. We have to understand this and plan accordingly. We have abundant natural resources, but we are not putting them to proper use. Of late, we started now utilizing, harnessing sun. Now we are planning to have maximum gigawatts of solar energy. You know the advantage? By taking care of the nature, nature is taking care of you. Thermal power was 6 rupees 60 paise, something like that. And solar power is 2 rupees 60 paise. It may come down further. So the research and the technology helps you. Similarly, if you do more and more research, intense research, you will be able to bring down the cost of the water desalination. And also, you are going drilling. And there, the gas availability is very much there. That's an area where we have to focus, because we are hugely depending on imports from outside, oil and gas. That's another area which requires more attention. And then we must also take care of the seabed minerals. It's abundantly available. We are yet to get optimum utilization of the same. Renewable energy service, ocean energy, you are making progress in that also. You need to make much more progress. And then seaports. We are moving in the direction of having more and more ports, but you need to develop more and more ports and also shipping. And also encourage in the future even water transportation also. That will reduce your cost. And marine biotechnology research. And all this will also add to tourism also. So these are the areas where focus has to be, right? And I'm happy the Science and Technology Ministry, under the leadership of Dr. Harshavardhan, the able guidance of Sri Narendra Bhai Modi, is focusing its attention and coming out with more and more innovation. Innovation, incubation, out-of-box ideas, and coming with solutions which are cost-effective. They are the need of the hour. Science and technology, the ultimate aim is to make the people's life more comfortable, people's life more happy. That is the purpose of science and research. So we have to understand, and then the country itself has to focus, and we must develop this scientific spirit under the knowledge seeking right from early days, during from our school days itself. The blue economy will aid in achieving the 14th goal of United Nations Sustainable Development Goals, which is life below water. It states, quote, conserve and sustainably use the oceans, seas and marine resources for sustainable development, unquote. Blue economy also includes intangible economic benefits that may not be marketed, such as carbon sequestration, coastal protection, cultural values, and biodiversity. I am quite confident that NIOT's well-positioned to address the important challenges of blue economy, to understand and better manage various aspects of ocean sustainability, ranging from sustainable fisheries to ecosystems health to preventing pollution. While playing a sheet anchor role in sustainable management of ocean resources, NIOT must forge partnership and collaborations across the sectors and borders. There are many other organizations that are working. We should all do networking, exchange information, know the best practices, not only within India, across the globe also. That is the way forward. Niti Aayog has noted that oceans will become new centers of economic activity in this era of advanced technology. While oceans already account for significant trade and commerce in the fields of shipping, offshore oil and gas, fishing, undersea cables, and tourism, the emerging industries such as aquaculture, marine biotechnology, ocean energy, and seabed mining have the potential to create jobs and spur worldwide economic growth. There is a need to give a strong thrust to research activities and innovation in the areas of ocean energy, marine biology and biotechnology for the nation to become a leader in those sectors, and NIOT can be a forerunner for achieving this milestone. As many of you know, that the United Nations has announced decade 2021-30 as the decade of ocean science for sustainable development. I'm happy to note that India is committed to take proactive action towards a healthy and resilient ocean, or a healthy body, or a healthy nation can become a wealthy nation, not vice versa. So you have to take care of the health of the ocean, it will take care of your health also, so that you can add to the wealth. In view of the important role played by oceans, Minister of Earth Sciences has launched the Deep Ocean Mission, covering all aspects required for sustainable and environmentally safe harvesting of ocean resources. I wish the Ministry of Earth Sciences and NIOT all success in their ambitious project, Samudrayaan. We, as a nation, we have taken the Chandrayaan mission, space mission, now Samudrayaan, which envisages sending three Aquarius, two Aquarius to ocean depths with their manned submersible in next few years. With this, India will join the select club of nations to conquer both space and deep oceans. We don't want to conquer anybody. We were known as Vishwa Guru once upon a time. Students from across the globe used to come to Nalanda, Takshashila, Pushpagiri those days for acquiring knowledge, because this land is very fertile and knowledge is available. What is required is recognize the knowledge, upgrade the skill, then our children will excel. I'm happy that you are conducting camp this competition for these children. That is the way to encourage people. I'm happy to note that you have already initiated working towards several long-term goals. Before concluding, I would like to congratulate NIOT once again for reaching this milestone, and I am confident that NIOT will play a leading role in the coming years in developing cutting-edge technology for exploration of deep ocean resources and security of the Indian Ocean. I am very happy that I have been able to come here today, spend some time with you people, know what you are doing, what are the achievements, and still what are the goals that have to be achieved, and I came for the purpose of really complimenting you for the good work you are doing, and asking you to tell you also that there are many more challenges and we have to address those challenges. I wish you all the success and hope for a better future for you and for the country and nation as a whole. I wish NIOT all success in your future endeavors. I'm sorry I disappointed that photographer. In cinema, there will be retake. In public life, there is no retake. You have to understand. Thank you very much, Namaskar.